whew, that's all I've got today. Now, I wouldn't be able to hit shots as strong as I just did, and you can see the stats coming up in the corner here. It's a pretty strong 6-iron. I wouldn't be able to do that unless I was utilizing what Mike Austin used to call the six pairs of joints and levers. That would be the shoulders, elbows, wrists, hips, knees, and ankles. Now, the biggest difference between your favorite stars that you see on TV on the PGA Tour and your own personal game, if you're just kind of the average golfer, is that you are underutilizing the lower three pairs. The hips, knees, and ankles are simply too quiet in your golf swing and they need more activity. The average golfer tends to use the arms too much to supply the power, not enough of the legs. So right after this, I want to show you a great drill that's going to help you activate the three lower pairs of joints so you can knock the ball out there strong just like the players on TV do. Hey, this is Steve with hititlonger.com. I continue my journey to hit the ball longer and straighter than ever before. More fairways, more greens, because that just makes golf more fun. If you want to have more fun with your game this year and hit the ball a little longer and straighter off the tee, by all means, join me. Hit the subscribe button right down there. Like this video at the end, and please leave a comment down below. I would really love to hear from you. Okay, so look at the swings coming up here. The slow-mo swings of some of the top ball smashing PGA stars out there right now. What do they all have in common? Well, they're hitting shots this strong, let's say 300 yards or more in the air, almost on command whenever it's strategically appropriate. They're doing this because their lower body, hips, knees, ankles, are not just active, but explosive. Explosive is a good word to describe it. Now, my mentor, Mike Austin, always used to say that the correct utilization of the lower joints sets up fast hands. That's because the stepping over and the proper use of the lower body causes the torso to unwind faster, the arms to spin faster, and therefore your hands are moving faster when you snap through the golf ball. So let me show you one of my favorite drills that you can easily do when you go to the driving range, just when you warm up. All right, so you've gone and gotten your bucket of balls. The heavier and more full, the better. I've just got a half a basket here, but you want weight. Weight will be better for most of you. All I'm gonna do here, this is a warm-up exercise to do about 20 or 30 times before you start hitting the balls, just to get your body moving. And this is gonna help you train or wake up or activate the muscles and joints of the lower body. Here I'm gonna let the bucket hang and I'm gonna pin my upper left arm onto my pec muscle so the bucket is almost in the middle. Now I'm gonna reach over and hook my arm, keep that arm tight because I do not want the arm to try to contribute any power in the golf swing. The left arm is basically useless in the golf swing except for a little bit of activation of the wrist, but also to maintain the radius like the spoke of a wheel. By utilizing the hips, knees, and ankles, I'm gonna make the bucket swing back and forth like this, and one and two, and one and two, one and two. Let's look at it from the down the line angle. I'm gonna start this smoothly by kicking in my right knee so I can get the bucket started smoothly, a little forward press, and that's my and. So it's and one and two, and one and two. Knee to knee, I'm just swinging knee to knee. Okay, so now how did I do that? Well, I had this action going in my feet, in roll. Okay, and that in roll with a little bit of heel lift is gonna help push my knees to the center, just like that. If I can do that, and I can make my hips also tilt and turn back and forth like a pendulum, it's going to cause or stimulate my trunk to start turning. I do not want to try to prevent it from turning. I want to encourage my trunk to wind and unwind, reacting to the action I'm doing down below. So watch this. Wind, unwind, wind, unwind, all in rhythm. No arms in this swing. It's all legs activating the turn of the trunk. Now, once I've done that 20 or 30 times to kind of loosen up and kind of tell my body, give it the signal that today I want this motion to dominate my swing, just like the guys that I like watching on TV. They don't pick up their arms and try to hit the ball only with their tense arms, like a lot of average golfers do, but they rhythmically use all six pairs of levers, but especially explosively is the bottom three. And this is the difference where the guy on TV can hit the ball so much farther than the average golfer. All right, let's do one more swing so we can take a look at how that drill that I just did 20 or 30 times will now work its way into my everyday swing. And we'll take a look at it in slow-mo. So you could see that how strong my weight shift was working and my turn of my body is working because of the activity of the bottom three pairs of joints that I've really woken up with the bucket drill. Get them all used to moving back and forth in rhythm. Then I can just allow my arms to relax and take the free ride that my trunk is providing by rotating. So not pulling the club into the ball with no body, but instead shifting and turning the arms through the ball. It makes the swing look a lot more effortless, feel way more effortless, and yet you're going to get tons more power. So in this coming year, I want you to dedicate yourself to getting these muscles and joints of the lower body woken up, doing the correct action, so you can get more distance on your drives too. Hey, for over 100 more great videos and articles, head on over to my website, hititlonger.com. I'm Steve. Thanks so much for watching my channel. I really appreciate it. And as usual, I'll either see you in the next video or I'll see you longer and straighter down the fairway. Everybody take good care.